So the thing to understand about this first example is that the maximum slowdown is 32. There are only 32 threads in a warp, so no matter how many cases there are, no matter how many ways you can branch, you're not going to branch more than 32 ways in a single warp because there's only 32 threads in that warp. So again, the maximum here is going to be 32. 32x slowdown for just this segment of code, right, for this switch statement in particular. What about this case? We're going to switch on the thread index of y. So the thing you need to understand is that CUDA assigns thread IDs to warps in such a way that the X ID varies fastest, the Y ID varies slower, the Z ID varies slowest. And this is much more clear if I use a concrete example. So in my quiz question, I have a 64 by 16 thread block. So let's just draw that out. Here's thread with X ID 0, X ID 1, X ID 2, and so forth. And these are the Y IDs. So this first row has Y ID 1, the second row has Y ID 2, all the way down to Y ID 16. And when CUDA assigns these to warps, it will launch a warp with 32 threads comprising XIDs 0 through 31, then another warp, again with 32 threads, containing thread IDs 32 through 63, and yet another warp with YID equal to 1 and XID varying from 0 to 31, and so forth. So now we know the answer to our question. All of the threads in a given warp, in this case, belong to the same YID. They all have the same YID. And that means that we'll get no slowdown at all, because all of the threads will be branching to the same place. What about this next case where we've got a smaller thread block that has 16 by 16 threads? So, in this case, we only have 16 XIDs that it can assign to a warp before it has to change to the next YID and start assigning the next set of XIDs. So, all of these threads will be placed into a single warp, the first 16 in the first half of the warp, the next 16 in the next half of the warp. Next, all of these threads will be placed into a warp, and so on. And so now, as you can see, there are two different YIDs for the threads in a single warp. So we'll end up having to execute this code twice for this warp, once with one YID, once with the second YID. We'll end up with a total of a 2x slowdown.